My favorite reads of 2021. I'm gonna discuss them with you right now. Here's Alice from the past. When I'm recording this video, it's still 2021. But when you're seeing this video, it's 2022! Happy New Year! Do you guys have any New Year's resolutions? Revolutions would be nice. I'm trying to be like you, Mabo. Fireworks in the back. At the back of my house and at the front of my house. Ooh, I love this. We love the sound effects, we love it. I'm just gonna start with a book that I've read two times. Once last year and a second time this year. All the Things We Never Said by Yasmin Rahman. This book is about three girls. They are all suicidal and they go onto a website. The website will help you find someone who you can end your life with together. But the website gives them tasks and they get creepier and creepier. And you should just read it. There's a reason I've read it twice. I think I'm going to read it again in 2022. It's so good. Notes on a Nervous Planet by Matt Haig. I read this when I was graduating. The thing is, I have a love and hate relationship with my mobile phone. I am very addicted to it. I'm addicted to social media and to my phone. I scroll like crazy. Sometimes I'm on that phone way too long and I think at the end of the day, what the hell have I been doing, you know? And in this book, he writes about that problem, about people constantly being on the internet. I read it and I was like, yeah, I understand what you're saying. The back of the book says, this book might even change the way you spend your precious time on Earth. Well, I'm still addicted to my phone, but that's my New Year's resolution. I have to like minimize my screen time because it's not healthy. Just read it. The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. I bought this because of TikTok and I do not regret it. I might read this a second time in 2022. It's about a woman, she's an actress. Her name is Evelyn Hugo and she asks Monique if she can write her autobiography. So Monique visits her every day and hears her story and writes along. Amazing things happen, bad things happen, crazy stuff happened in her life, okay? You just can't put it down. And at the end, there's a plot twist. Like, for the story it's great, but it's horrible. It is horrible. There's a reason why everybody on TikTok was talking about this book this year. It is amazing. Amazing. Colleen Hoover. Verity? I think that's how you pronounce it. This book, it was sickening and I couldn't put it down. This is about a writer as
writers.
So she almost hit herself in the face with that book. Loan is a writer. She's being asked to be a ghostwriter for a woman who had an accident. And then she comes to their house and she does her research and reads all her old books, yada, yada, yada. And she discovers all this crazy stuff, right? It's crazy. I really enjoyed this book and I wanted to give it 4 stars. And at the on the last like 20 or 30 pages, I was like, I have to, what? What did I just read? I had to give it 5 stars. It's nothing like you would expect. Nothing, nothing. I love a good plot twist. It is good. Version Zero by David Yoon. This is such a good science fiction book. It's about the tech industry and someone works there. He wants to do good to the world. This story is very complicated. I don't know if I can explain it without giving any spoilers. I do not ever want to give spoilers. I hate it when people give spoilers. Oh yeah. He and his friends want to reboot the entire internet and they have a plan and somebody helps him and all hell breaks loose. It is crazy, okay? It is crazy. I might read this a second time as well. All the books that I have here are, maybe I'm just gonna read them all in January. I might as well, who cares? And I want to talk about Heartstopper. Normally I don't use an e-reader, I'm not really a fan, but there just was a day in summer and I was like, I want to read Heartstopper, but I'm not patient enough to go order it and wait for it, or too lazy to go to the store and buy it. So I bought Heartstopper 1 on my e-reader, and then I was like, I might as well buy 2, 3, and 4. I read the 4 parts in 2 days. I loved it. I can't wait for Heartstopper 5 to come. And now I want to know, what was your favorite book that you've read last year? Let me know in the comments below. Here's my social media. Here are some other videos. Here are some other videos to check out, and I'll see you next time. Bye.